stop. I'll go get the money.
Okay.
You go back to the
Thank you.
Promises and agreements in an informal way. All those conversations that were held riding in a car or over a meal or during long walks, all those sentences that began with, when we're married, and continued with, I will, and you will, and we will. All those late night talks that concluded someday, somehow, maybe, and all those promises that are unspoken matters of the heart. All of these common things and more are the real process of a wedding. The symbolic vows that you're about to make are a way of saying to one another, you know all those things that we've promised and hoped and dreamed? Well, I meant it, every word. Look at one another and remember this moment in time. Before this moment, you have been many things to one another. Acquaintance, friend, companion, lover, dancing partner, and even teacher. But you have learned much from one another in these last few years. Now you shall say a few words that take you across the threshold of life, and things will never be quite the same between you. For after these vows, you shall say to the world, this is my husband, this is my wife.
And a big round of applause to I feel that you are too distant from one another today. But 10 years ago, I casually said to this couple who was getting married in this garden, this was the secret garden. The secret is there's always wind in here. So after 10 years, and there is such beautiful spiritual poetry, obviously, to the bride and groom. Will you please welcome Sarah with another big round of applause.
That you can direct the course of love. For love, if it finds you worthy, directs your course. Love has no other desire but to fulfill itself. But if you love and must needs have desires, let these be your desires. To melt and be like a running brook that sings its melody to the night. To know the pain of too much tenderness. To be wounded by your own understanding of love and to plead willingly and joyfully. To wake at dawn with a winged heart and give thanks for another day of loving. To rest at the noon hour and meditate on love's ecstasy. To return home at eventide with gratitude. And then to sleep with a prayer for the beloved in your heart and a song of praise on your lips. Then Almitra spoke again. And asked, what of love, what of marriage, master? And he answered, saying, you were born together, and together you shall be forevermore. You shall be together when the white wings of death shatter your days. Aye, you shall be together even in the silent memory of God. But let there be spaces in your togetherness, and let the winds of heaven dance between you. Love one another and make love not your bond. Let it rather be a moving sea between your shores of your souls. Fill each other's cup, but drink not from one cup. Give one another your bread, but eat not from the same loaf. Sing and dance and be joyous, but let each one of you be alone. Even as the strings of a lute are alone, though they quiver with the same music. Give your hearts, but not to each other's keeping. For only the hand of life will contain your hearts. And stand together, yet not too far apart. For the pillars of the temple stand apart. And the oak to tree and the cypress grow, not each other's shadow.
And a big round of applause to Sam.
And now this beautiful wisdom will be delighted for us by Aoife, which she will delight us with amazing grace. Reminds us all today to recall the wonder and uniqueness of our own relationships. For watching you both at this very precious moment, we are also inspired why we fell in love with our own partners, and so many here present will remarry deep in their hearts. Yashama is best friend, confident, lover. You make every single day an exciting challenge, and then together with your beautiful boy. I know that you both share a deep love and mutual passion, not only for one another, but also for Italy, as you have chosen this as the common ground for this beautiful day, and obviously to commence a new chapter. The crystallization of your mutual bond has led you from a place which is important to you both, for your families, here to Italy, and will soon transport you once again high crosses. In order for you to start a new life, or as Dante would say, una vita nuova, just tanto gentile e tanto di umiltà vestuta, e par che sia una cosa venuta da cielo e terra a miracol mostrare, e par che delle sue labbra si muova uno spirito soave, pieno d'amore, che va dicendo all'anima, sospira. Well, the final lines of Dante's famous sonnet perfectly express the way Jesper feels at the mere sight of the lady he so completely adores, who is delightful to those who behold her. Through her gaze, she offers to the heart a sweetness which no one has never experienced and could ever understand. There seems to issue from her lips a gentle spirit, full of love, that keeps on commanding to the soul to sigh. Rebecca, these words, they seem to, although they were written many centuries ago, they seem still modern and applicable to you. They say that love is a friendship which has caught fire. Well, today, you will lucky to know they will always be there for you, no matter what. They will do everything in his power to make you feel supremely special and to love you in a manner so that you so richly deserve. As he beholds you now as the loveliest bride, his happiness knows no bounds, and he cannot wait to embark upon many wonderful journeys together with the woman he could never live without, Jasper. Rebecca couldn't wish for a more thoughtful, kind, and intelligent husband. You are such fun to be around, and your dry sense of humor is irresistible. You are blessed with an inner sense of calm and a logical mind, which Rebecca greatly admires. You constantly support her in matters of the heart and encourage her professional aspirations. Everything she has achieved means more because of your genuine interest. Today, Rebecca would like you to know that she is extremely grateful for the way in which you have inspired her to embrace the opportunity, such as the only place in the world that Rebecca wishes to be is in your arms, and all that is needed is the warmth of your embrace to make her feel special, to make her feel protected, to make her feel your princess. You make her happier than she's ever thought it was possible to be, and will always do her utmost to ensure a loving and caring home environment in which you can both grow together with your beautiful son, Lucas. Rebecca looks forward to many happy years of creating incredible memories and spending time in Ireland and in Denmark. She cannot imagine sharing her life with anyone else, for you are the handsome prince, best friend, greatest fan, soulmate and partner in crime. You both wisely value the creation of memories more than the illusion of material things. You derive immense pleasure from each other's company and share a wonderful sense of humor, which is a great asset for all of us, not just for them, and curiosity of the world around you. For you are never happier than when exploring new sights and sounds. But you are already blessed to have found the one rare person in this life. With whom you can be completely relaxed and be yourself without the need to hide anything or pretend to be someone else. As you now undertake to declare your intention to remain dedicated to ensuring one another's happiness, may you remember this moment of excitement and anticipation, which of course will be only the first of many, spend in loving companionship as you now prepare to become husband and wife. The tenderness of pure emotion is an expression of the desire to be honest that Jasper and Rebecca will offer to one another. And now, Jasper, I will invite you to gaze through Rebecca's eyes like the first time that you saw her. At least we got him to relax now. Jasper, will you have this woman to be your wife, to live together in marriage? Will you love, comfort, honor, and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
You have to think about it. And now, before we hear a word, Rebecca has to say, Rebecca, will you have this man to be your husband, to live together in marriage? Will you love, comfort, honor, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
Hello.
Thank you. This beautiful, simple acknowledgement that they offer to one another are the keys unlocking the secrets of their hearts for them to know and for all of us to support them. So to honor this tender moment now, before Rebecca and Jasper offer each other the most beautiful gift, which are the rings, in which they represent the gift of the land for one another, I would like to invite Neil to share the blessing of the hands. Thank you.
These are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and full of love for you, that are holding yours on your wedding day as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future. These are the hands that will love you and cherish you through the years and will comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will hold you when fear or grief fills your mind. These are the hands that will countless times wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow and joy. These are the hands that will tenderly hold your children. These are the hands that will help you to hold your family as one.
beautiful romantic and spiritual blessing of your hands now prepares you to be one another's best friend, confident, lovers, but also a great example to your son. Jesper and Rebecca are bound to exchange places in an outward symbol of commitment for their meet today before you. From the ancient times, the ring has been a symbol of wedded love, an unbroken and never-ending circle just like this one. Symbolizes commitment to a love which is also never-ending. Now may I please invite the best man to present Jesper and Rebecca with rings, and you each take each other's rings. Yes, and now Jesper. And now Jesper, may I please invite you to place ring just at the tip of Rebecca's finger? And will you please repeat after me? Rebecca, with this ring, I be one.
Rebecca, with this ring, I be one.
Where it is a symbol.
Where it is a symbol.
Of our loving commitment.
Of our loving commitment.
Thank you, Jesper. You may offer the ring. Rebecca, today you marry your best friend. With this ring, you also offer Jesper your hand, your heart, your soul. Will you please place the ring just at the tip of his finger? As you please speak up to me, Jesper, with this ring, you might be well. Where it is a symbol of our loving commitment. Thank you, Rebecca. You may offer the ring. Will everybody please give Rebecca Jesper a big round of applause? Jesper, in the case of Africa. Jesper suffer all the way to the end. And now will you please welcome once again the people.
And my father won't.
it will not be long, love, till our wedding day. Thank you.
Den finder ikke sin glæde i uretten, men glæden, den glæder sig med sandheden. Den tåler alt, tror pas.
Therefore, as a minister and a registrar, not only is a pleasure, but it is a great honor to pronounce you both husband and wife. And Jessica, you make us your bride again. And to thank Jasper and Rebecca for having invited me to be a small part here. I came from Tuscany today to bring a very special gift here. This is was a handmade parchment certificate made by a 95 young man who sadly passed away last year. He was the last of a company in Florence which dates back in 1700. I hope that every time you look at this certificate, you will remember this beautiful day with your family and friends. So may I please invite you now to sign together with your witnesses. Tonight you will be dancing to music that you have specifically chosen for your day, I'm sure. But remember that as good dancers or skaters, to keep a close eye contact, because sometimes you need to move apart, but you always return into synchronicity to one another. This music, ladies and gentlemen, will not only play today during their wedding day, but throughout their life. Will you please welcome for the very first time the newlyweds, Rebecca and Jasper. The stage is all yours.
Yeah, the book.
Do you want to see your soul?
Melodia d'amore.